Hello and welcome to Goa 365's Face to Face. With me is a very eminent personality. He's a lawyer, he's been a union minister, no less than a law minister of the union government. And today he's a politician, but today he's on this program. We want to talk to him about the Lokayukta, the act, the bill, the amendments. So welcome to our show, sir.
Thank you so much. Happy to be with you.
Sir, what I want to say now, there has been a lot of hype over this Lokayukta, right from the IAC days and after that that agitation which happened in Delhi, and then an offshoot of that agitation was AAP, which took over in, which is in power in Delhi at this moment.
Right.
And then Lokayukta and lot. So could you give us a background starting from the why that Lokayukta, reason and all
okay,
that?
Okay, if you want to ask me, to begin from the beginning itself. That's the way it is. You know, we can talk about Adam and Eve.
Let's not go so
and
far.
And the story in the Genesis, which says that the first
in the beginning,
when this creation was there and people were there, and they all became corrupt, and there was a huge deluge, and they were all decimated.
Yeah.
God did that.
Yes.
So if that can happen with those days, you can imagine what will happen now. And our greatest economist of the past, Kautilya, has said that any revenue officer, you know, given the charge of collecting revenue, etc., tends to taste a part of it. It's like putting honey on your your tip of your tongue.
Correct.
Or even poison.
Correct.
It goes in.
Absolutely. Yes.
So that is the bad part of it. And then this corruption has, you know, gone on and on, on and on. No country has spared of this. Whether it is today's governance, democratic governance, or dictatorships, or Rajeshahi, whatever, in those parts. Every time this has happened. So much so that we have a nice story by Birbal. They say Birbal found a certain officer in his administration. Wherever you put him, you can't just prevent him from, you know.
He knew what to do.
So frustrated, he was put in, it seems, by the side of the sea, and said, come on, you sit here, do nothing. And then he ended up making money there also. So
counting the waves.
He started counting waves. That whole story
is
there.
Yes.
So now, this thing has to be curbed. There are no two opinions about it. And United Nations created a meeting, brought about a meeting, about 140 countries got together. And they all said, okay, we want to put an end to this menace of corruption the world over. So how to do it? So this concept of ombudsman came in.
Yes.
There should be ombudsman at all levels, whenever the public feels, any person has to make a complaint. Okay, you go to the ombudsman, he inquires. Not just inquires, he indicts, he prosecutes, and whatever judgments that come thereafter. So this concept, you know, evolved over a period of time in various countries, in various organizations. Not just only in the ministries, in the governance as such, but the other wings of government, public authorities, it came in. It came in schools, it came in colleges, it came in universities, banks, wherever. So ombudsman all over. Now to regulate all that, a time came how exactly one is to proceed. So if there is a statute which governs the entire appointment of an ombudsman, his powers, his functions, and so on and so forth, it was always thought that it would be a good thing. So we had this Commission Inquiries Act.
Mm.
We had this Public Inquiries Act, Public Men's Corruption Act in Goa, and all sort of things. You mentioned India Against Corruption.
Yes.
So that was a movement which really galvanized the people of India in a big way. Anna Hazare was at the forefront of it. And out of that, a lot of things happened. Out of that, the UPA government, you know, got a severe beating.
Yes.
Out of this India Against Corruption movement. Then came the formation of AAP, and we have in Delhi now a government by Kejriwal, who was a part of that India Against Corruption. Government of India itself, you know, they circulated model bills for Lokayukta and Upalokayukta. A bill was introduced in the Lok Sabha also, in the parliament as well. In Goa, on our part, our government also tried to bring about a Lokayukta concept, and finally we have a bill today, which is the Lokayukta.
We have
the Lokayukta Act here. Now, before this Lokayukta bill was enacted in the assembly, The present ruling party, then led by Manohar Parrikar, was vehemently in favor of a very strong, stringent, you know, effective Lokayukta organization.
Correct.
And that was something which you all appreciated. But when that bill came in, it became an act and all that, we found it was diluted. It didn't have the necessary powers that a Lokayukta should have. For example, out of any transaction, sometimes, say, some untoward incident comes to the notice of the public. Or it comes to the notice of the Lokayukta as well.
Yes.
So he can take a suo moto action against that particular thing. Then there is a complaint filed by any individual or organization, a group of individuals. Or government itself feels that, you know, responding to the public outcry, they refer this issue to the Lokayukta. And the Lokayukta is supposed to inquire into that. Now, how does he inquire? Does he have the wherewithal with him, the machinery with him to inquire? So he requires actually an investigation wing,
okay,
manned by some experienced personnel. Of course, they will be led by the government itself. So he can pick and choose
who he wants,
according to whom he wants, and they are entrusted with the power to investigate. Now, at the end of investigation, supposing a prima facie case is made out. Now, such a person, such an authority against whom such an inquiry is held has to be prosecuted. Now, who does the prosecution? So, he should have a prosecution wing. We have seen this in Karnataka.
I was going to say Hegde.
Hegde, he had a prosecution wing with him.
Correct.
So, investigation wing culminates in some sort of a report. If that report is against, find there is a genuine finding in it, then comes the prosecution. So, prosecution wing comes in. And then the matter goes where, usually, if it is suppose a public authority like a chief minister or a minister or an MLA or an MP and a person of that stature, he should come out clean, if he is clean. And how long should it take? In a normal procedure that we all have in this country, you file any complaint against anyone and it takes donkey's years, years and years, and you never come to know that. Ultimately, people forget that such a huge corruption issue was against him.
Mm.
And he says, where is the finding against me? Who has found me guilty?
Mm. Correct.
So you need a special courts for this purpose. Every case, but
fast track. Are you looking at fast track?
I would say a special court.
Okay.
To do this. Now our Lokayukta here, you know, has indicted about 23 reports have been given, and each report there is something or other.
Correct.
Who has investigated in a proper way? Who is prosecuted? Then the act talks about sanction. Now, if after having appointed a Lokayukta who is supposedly a retired judge of a high court or a supreme court, at least respect his stature.
Of course.
After that investigation, he says, yes, I find that this man is guilty of such and such an offense. Now, he has to be properly prosecuted. Now, you say that, come on, take my sanction. The government prescribes, the law prescribes that sanction of the government is required. If sanction is required, will the government ever give a sanction?
Against its own people, very, very.
Do you give it? Take the example of those mining leases which were renewed by the local government. Names are two. One chief minister, of course, is not with us. But the other gentleman is there. 66 cases of renewal of mines in a fraction of how many? I don't know. Seconds or minutes?
Yeah, almost.
Forget about hours.
Almost, yeah.
When the national law, the ordinance was in force that mining leases, no more mining leases, but auctions will be there and coming into force on a particular date. From a particular, on that date, such a thing comes up and the Lokayukta points the fingers. Now, if you want sanction, who will give the sanction? Against whom will the ruling party give a sanction? Opposition, if there is no question of sanction, because they are not in government.
Yeah.
So they will be prosecuted, but anyone within the government, hardly anybody, any time, you can think of any sanction being.
This was the original law.
This should have been the framework of actual law.
Okay.
What we have was these two things were not there actually speaking.
And now
investigation, prosecution, and now it is further diluted during now that the new amendments which have been introduced and all that, the sanction part is now is more strengthened.
Okay.
So as a result, the law itself is, I would say, was and he is toothless. Now, whatever one or two teeth perhaps that law had have also been extracted now. So, very unfortunate. People can rest assured.
The guilty, you mean, or people who...
People can rest assured. If you want to make noise, please go ahead and make it. You will have some good entertainment for whoever wants it. Nothing can come out of the present system that we have, unless people themselves really rise up and force upon the government. I would say, you know, if I had the opportunity, I would go by the report which Law Commission of Goa gave. 15th report of Law Commission, given in September 2011. Then government, Congress government, I was the chairman of that commission,
Law Commission. Okay.
And after studying the various model bills and considering the views of the public, we prepared a model bill, Lokayukta for Goa. In that, we provided for investigation wings and prosecution wings for the Lokayukta. We also said that this Lokayukta should be above board. There should be no temptation, lure for him, or expectation that after retirement from that post, he will get some
something else,
government post or something of that sort. So there's a clear-cut provision in that bill we provided, of course, the draft bill, that he shall not hold any public office thereafter. So totally secluded from all these temptations, favoritism, nepotism, because he himself may be guilty of nepotism and favoritism. Okay. So these were the provisions, and I think that if Goa has to progress in a real way, whichever government that comes to power next should assure the people of Goa now before they go to the public, that we shall have a full-proof machinery in the form of a Lokayukta with all full powers. Any public authority, whether it is the chief minister or whether it is a panchayat member, whether he is a chairman of university, vice chancellor, or the principal or the administrator of a school or a college running, or a headmaster, or director of education or headmaster. So anyone, any organization getting, say, a certain amount of grants from the government of Goa. Because there are hundreds of institutions, hundreds of, many of them mushroom
Whenever there's a need. Overnight, yes.
And then they go to the government and they take 5 lakh rupees, 10 lakh rupees.
Yes.
Football clubs take it, cricket clubs take it, then your language groups take it, drama groups take it. God knows, hundreds of them, they take money. That money is out of people's pockets.
Yes.
It's collected by the government.
It's public.
And it is distributed. Quite often it is, it's a gesture of so-called earning goodwill by the MLAs, by the ministers, by the chief minister and all that. So they do it. So you float an organization. And that organization says, I want to organize this of cultural event, so-called cultural event. And then they go to the government, and government gives freely some grants to them, 10 lakhs, 15 lakhs, 20 lakhs. Do they spend it properly? So not only at that level should the Lokayukta should be able to go, right from the top to the chief minister's level, down to this level, down below. Everywhere where the government expenditure is involved, everywhere the grants are given, you can prescribe a limit. Say 1 lakh and more. Any organization getting in a year a grant of say 1 lakh or more, if there is some hanky-panky there, if there is some misappropriation there, some mishandling of the public funds is involved, anyone from the public can make a complaint. Suo moto organization, the Lokayukta could take cognizance of it. And in bigger cases where, a lot of agitation takes place and then government is forced, government gives an assurance in the government, okay, we'll refer it for inquiries.
But let me just interrupt you, sir. Now, suppose if that investigation wing independent is not there and a prosecution wing independent is not there, what is the point of unnecessarily having the Lokayukta?
Asked the right question. What is the point?
The opposition was making it, why waste the money on
exactly, you are wasting more money on that organization, which is, what is it, not even a paper tiger.
Yeah, exactly. What is the point, according to you? Now, exactly. You have been a law minister of
exactly, the nation. Exactly, that is why I have been always making this point. In fact, my report, that's September 2011 report, exactly prescribes how a Lokayukta should be, what powers we should have and how we should proceed in this functioning. Now, if you do not provide any of these things, then you are creating some sort of a naam ke waste, some organization, some post there,
to keep somebody,
put somebody there, make somebody happy, keep him there. A person like Mishra doesn't get happy there, you know, he looks at it and gives his report
back.
But there are many who would say, Maro Goli, if there are no powers with me, what am I to do?
The sad part is, the Congress got destroyed because of corruption. It got destroyed completely in a way. Now, I don't know if my facts are right, but I this year itself, I think the corruption index, the country has dropped, you are aware of?
Yes, I am aware of it. I was told that the country has dropped some 7-8 points.
6 places, yeah.
By some 6 places or 7-8 places. So that means in the corruption index, we are once again reaching those...
No, it's gone even lower.
Yeah, that means in the Committee of Nations, we'd be looked at as a corrupt nation.
Yeah, but that is not a very... good way to go forward. No,
if it we are, is not a good way to go
if
forward.
If we want to be, see, we have today, we have the confidence, we have the ability, we show. But corruption, with this corruption and with this, the way successive state governments are diluting this Lok Ayog, the diluting their fight against corruption, where do you think, what is the chance for the
this
nation?
Is exasperating. You know, we are playing with the public opinion. We are taking people for granted. This is the unfortunate part of it. So there has to be a specific categorical action on the part of the ruling and as well as on the part of the opposition. Those who are the opposition should categorically say, this is the new law I am going to have. And the present dispensation should say, what is existing today is not sufficient. So we are going by what the original suggestions were made by the organization called India Against Corruption, IAC. Why not adopt those methods? Why do you dilute the existing powers here?
And IOC, the offshoot of the IOC, besides AAP, the offshoot of the IOC, that the Congress was destroyed.
Congress was destroyed.
It's never really recovered from
it. See, we were told that the entire amount, black money lying in the Swiss banks would be brought back and each individual would get 15 lakhs.
Yeah.
This statement everybody remembers. Nobody forgets that.
We discuss
but
it
then
often.
Why do we make a mockery of ourselves? First by making such grandiose statements and then not adhering to it. So that sends a bad message down the line. Kya hoga hamara? Nobody will take any action. Chalo, karo.
Sir, now you're an advocate, former law minister, senior politician in Goa. All this I agree, but people believe, I feel from the way the election result, people believe that these type of statements could possibly happen. It's always like, okay, fine, there's an apple somewhere we are going to get. People believe. Otherwise, how would it make sense that they are voting for the same dispensation again and again?
Again.
I'll bring the Congress hat on to you, and the Congress, which is in opposition, which is shouting that thing, this is happening, it's not been able to reach the people. There has to be some sort of a, I don't know.
Appears to be some sort of a disconnect.
Total.
In many ways, in many aspects of it. Okay, what is the tendency if the opposition, see, we lost out of 17, we lost 12 people. 12,
yeah,
12.
Yeah.
Left with 5.
Yes.
Okay. Now people say, if that is going to happen, kya hoga? They better not be with the ruling party, good or bad, whatever they are doing, we can get some largesse, benefit out of some largesse.
But then why bother with Lok Ayukta and ACB and all? Ultimately,
but
why?
Okay. But as a responsible democratic setup, we cannot let such a thing happen. We should not.
Because we are letting it happen.
Never settle with such a thing.
Okay.
Things will be bad. Like pandemic. Recently we had this COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, act of God, we say, just leave it. No, we all fought, isn't that?
Correct.
Every individual fought. Every individual shut himself, locked himself out of everything else.
Correct.
And then we could fight. Of course, then there was a vaccine has been now introduced.
Yes.
Government did their job. There were a lot of COVID warriors and all that. So there have to be warriors against corruption as well. You cannot, you know, allow people to feel disillusioned with the democratic setup. Then one day they will say, why do we need elections? Why do we need all this? If the same corrupt thing is going on, if one individual is going to be a money man and muscle man, and okay, chalo. You give the powers in his hands and slip
but
back.
That's where the opposition plays an important
role. It is our job. You know, like many opposition parties come to power and forget what they have said before the election.
Yeah.
I think it is equally applicable to Congress and BJP or and anybody else.
Or the others.
Okay. Any setup for that matter in this country, it applies to them. But this debate must remain alive. We cannot allow public perception to be disillusioned and be forgetful of what is happening to us.
So we need a very, what is this what I am understanding what you are saying? That we need a very strong Lokayuta.
We need a strong Lokayuta.
And the politicians have to be pushed by the people to ensure that happens.
Exactly, that they have to do. And once the Lokayuta is appointed, it is for the public to rake as many things that they come across. Issues of corruption, nepotism, favoritism, you know, what sort of things. To bring this to the notice of the Lokayuta.
First, we need an act which is effective.
Effective. You need a strong act for this purpose. And that is what I have been telling all the both government and the opposition now. You know, you appointed a law commission. We sat there for about 2 years, we worked and we gave you almost 3 dozen reports on various aspects. Please read at least those. They're gathering dust.
<That's>
Wherever they are, God knows where they have dumped them, those reports.
Do you have a copy of that?
I do have a copy. It's available on the, from day one I put it in public domain.
Okay.
So if you, Google Goa Law Commission, then you get the reports, everything you get on that.
Today you are heading that party. At least you're trying to reorganize the party, reorganize, whatever way they are all semantics, it's just language. So, would that be one of the things that you would tell the people whom you get into the organization? Array, look, there is a disconnect between us and the. See, there is a disconnect, forget in the state. This is, of course, my opinion. It's my. There's also probably a disconnect even in the country. The elections are not maximum, it will be a year, probably earlier.
But February maximum. 2022 is the official date.
Yes.
Now, it could be held 6 months before that.
Exactly.
Which means in October.
October, November,
elections can be anytime.
Yes.
Now, there's a Damocles sword hanging on the heads of those 12
so
people.
Many,
10 plus 2, 10 people there. If it comes heavily on their head, they all go home.
It's gone.
Then what happens to the government? Certainly, they will not like the opposition to come to the power.
No.
So they will propose this dissolution of the house and then elections.
Yeah.
Whatever way, Goa will go for elections.
Soon.
Maybe in 6 months, 8 months, 10 months.
Soon.
Very soon we will have to go. For that purpose, people of Goa are definitely looking at alternatives. They always do it.
Yes.
Every 5 years, people look for an alternative.
Yes.
Whichever dispensation is in power, good, bad. If it is bad, they want to remove it. If it is good, they may give it a
little bit of chance.
Now, Congress is a opposition party.
It's
no doubt it lost its MLAs.
It's a non-brand, whatever.
Yeah. No doubt it has lost its MLAs in the House. Does it mean that the rank and file has been totally dissolved? They
Absolutely not.
They are there. They are waiting for somebody to come and tell them, pat their back and say, come on, boy, let's start it again. So, this is my job. As the president or chairman of the coordination committee for the whole state of Goa, appointed by the AICC, my mandate is clear. Go to the grassroots, membership at the booth level, and then brick by brick you build the edifice.
Sir, we have run out of time. I think we've crossed the time. It was good, but your point is well taken. Now it's up to the government, the people first, I think, and the opposition, and then the government to basically, if they want Goa to reach somewhere else, very important. Lokayuta is important, governance is important, not just elections and winning elections. So, thank you very much for being with us today. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. You know, it's a good opportunity.
Thank you. And keep watching Goa 365.